You know, the subject of twins is always fascinating to people. They either do or do not understand what twins are all about. I'm just wondering, was it difficult growing up knowing there was a little clone of yourself, right, living with you, playing with you, going to school with you?
Well, like I said, you know, we didn't know anything differently, and, you know, he's not my clone.
You know, a lot of times people would ask, so what's it like to be a twin? And the response I would usually give is, well, what's it like not to be a twin? I mean, it's just, it is what it is.
It's more like he's my brother, but we just happen to have the same birthday to me.
Did you guys take the same classes? Did you have same similar academic interests as you went to school?
Yeah, I think I took the harder classes because, you know, he had a hard time with those.
You know, I think we just naturally gravitated towards similar interests because, you know, maybe it's somewhat genetically based, but also because we were always, you know, exposed to the same things growing up, and I think that somehow, you know, drives what you're interested in. So, you know, as far as, you know, maybe academic stuff, but also like what kind of sports and other interests were similar because of our, you know, similar upbringing.
I think that throughout high school, I can only remember of being in one class together.
Just Spanish. Worked.
Oh, okay, then two. Spanish, yeah. And biology in 12th grade. AP biology.
You know, in elementary school, for instance, we were never allowed to be in the same class. I don't know if that was a school system policy or it was my parents' desire, but that was actually, you know, prohibited. And then later in like junior high and high school, it was very rare for us to be in the same class.
Did you guys double date to further confuse the social situation?
Never. Never thought about it.
No. Deliberately or just by coincidence?
Well, I think, you know, it's, you know, if you had any brothers or sisters, you probably didn't go on double dates with them and their girlfriend or boyfriend. It's kind of like the same thing. It's a little bit odd.
I don't think I've ever gone on a double date with anyone. So,
did you ever pull pranks in school by impersonating each other?
Actually, not one time. And I think it was because very early on, we would get a lot of pressure to do that. And we just didn't want to, you know, go with the peer pressure. I mean, I would say almost weekly, somebody would say, you guys should do this, you should switch classes, you know. So we, you know, very early on, we just said, no, we're not going to do that.
I think we were saving up for the big prank someday, and we have the perfect opportunity now.
Who's got the better sense of humor, speaking of pranks?
I don't know.
That's for somebody else to decide.
While you were in school, as you went along year to year, who actually, you may not want to admit this, but who had the better grades? Who was the better student?
He did, clearly, until we got to college. I was a little less serious in, you know, going through elementary school, junior high, and high school. I was more interested in kind of what was going on outside of the classroom versus inside. And then, you know, later when I got into college, I decided I wanted to, you know, fly Navy airplanes and, you know, eventually be a test pilot. So I took my schoolwork more seriously.
I don't think I remember him ever once doing homework.
Yeah, I did pretty good for for doing very little homework, yeah. Actually, considering, you know, the level
Mark
of effort.
Probably doesn't want to admit that, but that would imply that he's the smarter of the two.
Well, he did more homework,
yeah.
And he had better grades, I think is what that would imply.
Let's talk for a second about your folks. How did they handle twins?
I don't know how my mother...
From the earliest of your recollection.
I don't know how my mother handled us as little kids. I certainly wouldn't have been able to. I mean, we were kind of, you know, pretty wild and would fight with each other all the time. And so I really got to hand it to her for putting up with us and not, you know, dropping us off at an orphanage.
Yeah. Pretty much every day we would get into fist fights. So it was tough for my mom. She'd try to break them up, you know, and then, you know, some of these fights would last hours and hours.
Because we were so evenly matched.
Yeah.
Born out of what? What caused you guys to fight? Just natural...
Hatred. Natural hatred. for one another until the fight was over, and we were friends.
You know, we there were actually some other twins other than the Sarneys. I remember a couple other guys in the neighborhood. And a similar situation. You know, I think it's very common for twins or siblings that are about the same age to be in this constant conflict.
Did your folks ever play favorites that you can remember?
Absolutely not. No. They've always been very good at trying to be, you know, treat us exactly the same.
And even today, you know, you could sometimes get a sense that they want to be, you know, exactly the same with each of us, even at, you know, 46 years old.
What influence would you say they had on you as you were growing up? What was the most important thing that they encouraged you to do or steered you to doing?
For me, the major influence that I can remember them having is that they always encouraged the both of us that nothing was beyond our abilities. So although, you know, there were times where I didn't really know what I wanted to do and what kind of opportunity I had, what, you know, opportunities were out there, I always knew and had a sense for if I really, you know, decided that I wanted to do something, be something, you know, put enough effort into it, it was achievable.
I think the other influence might be because they were both police officers, that the, you know, it was this kind of subtle influence of don't get into too much trouble. I mean, I remember getting into, you know, the normal kind of trouble that a young, you know, kid in the neighborhood would get into, but there was certainly this line out there because of, you know, our parents were both police officers in the town.
Were they strict, though, with you?
They actually gave us a lot of freedom. You know, my dad worked nights mostly, and while we were growing up, and my mother also worked, so there were times where when it was just the two of us at home, and, you know, they gave us a pretty long leash, actually.
What kind of students were you guys in overall? I mean, you talked about sort of the IQ thing and the fact that one of you had to study and do more homework, but overall...
Well, it's not that he had to study and do more homework. It's that he did more homework, studied, and did better in school, which is, you know, understandable. And I did less and did worse.
Were you guys athletes back then?
Yeah, we were actually co-captains of the swim team for a couple of years, right? 11th and 12th grade.
Yeah, 11th, 12th grade. And then
we were both on the track team, played baseball when we were younger, played Pop Warner football. I mean, both Little League and Pop Warner was something we did for, boy, I mean, it probably seemed like 10 years. They have, you know, great programs in the town for both those sports. So we kept pretty busy.
On the same teams?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, always, actually.
Always, yeah.
Always on the same team.
Did both of you always, as you grew up and matured and started looking at, you know, post-high school, college, a career, did you always have similar career paths, or was there enough of a difference in your interests to lead you in different directions at some point?
Well, initially there was. I mean, I went to the U.S. Merchant Marine Academy, and Scott actually took a totally different path for a while, going to the University of
Maryland. Yeah, I went to the University of Maryland for a year and was considering maybe, you know, being a medical doctor, but decided, you know, my other interest was maybe flying airplanes in the Navy. Just kind of changed my mind and changed schools and changed majors and decided, you know, to focus 100% on that. So he's actually a year senior to me in the Navy.
I actually remember going to visit him at the University of Maryland, probably towards the end of his first year, and then showing him all the pictures of Navy airplanes and telling him I was going to go ahead and do this.
That's not how I remember it.
And then he said something like,
"Yeah, right.
That sounds a lot better than being a doctor."
That's not how I remember it.
No fistfights on the set.